Hello everybody and welcome back to Enter the Gungeon with me, Flick. Hopefully with less salt this time now that we've finally got the hard part of Elevator Man out of the way. He's now looking for 20 hegemony credits, we'll definitely have that by the time we get down to him, assuming we live that long. But let's not talk about the High Priest or whatever the hell he's called, because he is garbage. Also, my headset appears to be way too loud for this game and I need to turn it down, I'm getting deafened. Die quickly. Alright, hang on. 1 second. Ooh, that's better. Okay. Let's get back into it. The worst part is over. Still haven't beaten the Lich yet. I should probably try and focus on that, I suppose. But I do want to just get the Elevator Man stuff done so I never need to talk about it again. And we'll need to keep a lookout for a few more capabilities. I think they can only appear on the later floors, so I don't remember ever seeing them earlier than, say, floor 3. Alright, well, that's good if I get hit a couple of times. Actually, you know what the best part is? The best part is I can go back to opening chests if I want to, which I obviously do, because I've had too many runs where I've had to rely on starting weapons. That said, I do still want to see what quality chests I have to pick from first. Because we're not going down to the sewer level, we can just find chests and we can actually open them and hopefully actually get strong for a change. I was actually doing some reading on the subreddit back when I was still salt infused from the last time I was recording this. I'm definitely not the only one who, after a point, kind of gives up on Gungeon just because the later game stuff isn't very fun. And I hope that's something they choose to address rather than ignore or, you know, go the darkest dungeon dev route of saying, well, this is our vision, we don't care if you don't like it. Because it does seem to be the majority that has a problem with the endgame, most people don't actually get to the endgame of Gungeon because they get too frustrated earlier than that. Also, well, this is second hand, so it might not be true, but on the subreddit at least I saw discussions about how most YouTubers who have been doing series on this actually give up. They don't necessarily, you know, they don't do everything, every single achievement, they don't get every possible ending, they don't bother going to bullet hell, they just quit before that because they get sick of the frustration that the game causes. So I'm glad that I'm not the only— oh hey, it's been a while since we've seen what's his face. I'm glad I'm not the only one, but at the same time, if that is true— also I'm not doing this one, I can't do that one. If it is true, and there's many people just kind of quitting playthroughs because they just have had all the fun sapped out of the game, that's something they should definitely consider addressing. Because the people who are doing it for— well, they won't all be professional YouTubers, but if there's people who are playing essentially to earn money for themselves, and yet they still get so sick of the game they just decide to give up, there's probably something up with the game. Because Gungeon is still popular, as far as I'm aware. So we have a key because we haven't found one. Phoenix, shotgun coffee. I keep forgetting what shotgun coffee does. That said, we're probably just going to buy the key. The Phoenix is probably on par with the pistol I've got, unless you're close enough that the fire it spits out actually hits something. Oh, water barrel right there. We're not going to the sewer level, so it doesn't matter. Although here's the fireplace right here. There's a water bottle in here too. Assuming this guy doesn't shoot it, which I think he just did. So yeah, key's going to be our first priority, assuming we can forward something else, which is very, very unlikely. The Phoenix was cheaper than hot coffee. I don't think it's called hot coffee. It's something coffee. There's our boss. We're not doing a run where I have to hold on to my keys, though, so I'd much rather find a chest. We haven't found any yet. Nope. Alright, so that's technically a full heart on the floor. It's pretty good. A brown chest, eh? Well, we might end up opening that rather than shooting it, but only if I knew for a fact that it's the chest that has a passive slash active in it. I don't really want an active, but I would try for a brown quality passive. I want a better than brown quality gun, ideally. Otherwise, we might just use the Marine's pistol on this floor and save the keys for floor 2. That saved me probably no time. It would have been faster if I just walked. Ooh, So as a random aside, well, will I talk about this now or will I wait? I'll wait until we see our other item room, but I do have a random tangent to go on, and it's been a while since I felt comfortable going off on random tangents during dungeon runs, because it takes so much mental focus to dodge bullet hell. More than Isaac, that's for sure. If you're used to playing Isaac. Two brown quality chests, wow. I think we might just skip and wait till the next floor. I could buy a guaranteed gun, even if it's not amazing. Or I could buy shotgun coffee. I think it's speed up. We'll buy shotgun coffee. Yeah. A speed up is okay. We're also guaranteed to get a gun from the boss. Now, we might get hit because I haven't had any... It's Bullet Twins. Because I haven't had any new guns, we'll accept the damage if we get hit, and we'll have to deal with it. Speed up might make it easier to dodge their bullets. It'll certainly make it easier late game to dodge, say, the kill pillars. Oh, incidentally, it was not in my imagination. There was a bug regarding the robot's jump not having enough iframes compared to every other character. I believe it's now been fixed, though. But I specifically remember, like, I think it was fighting the dragon, and I was doing correct dodges, but I was still getting hit. It was because there was a problem with the robot. So I'm glad I was not imagining things. And also keep in mind, there's quite a delay sometimes when I post these Gungeon episodes because they're low priority, and I don't mean that I don't care about them. I just mean that in terms of what I upload, there's things that people want to see more, so generally the Gungeon episodes are spaced out more. They're still coming, I'm still recording them, it's just, you know, you have to do a priority type thing when you're trying to not upload too many videos a day. Shit. I really wish that taking armor damage didn't count, but that's the world we live in currently. Goodbye. So yeah, we're gonna get robbed of an HP up by losing armor, I think. We can just give this guy a circle strafe, thanks to the speed up, and he can't catch us. Yeah, pretty much. Poor little fella, I wouldn't mind getting one of their guns from this boss fight. They're both pretty good. Yep, we lost no HP on that fight. Typical. We get the membrane? Yeah, it's okay, I think. Sadly, the ammo's going to get taken. I was going to say, hey, let's leave the ammo while we look for secret rooms, but the rat's going to have it. So yeah, I think because we got a reasonable gun, I'll save my key for the next floor. There's so many hearts on the floor. Getting a speed up early is handy. It's more handy than one single speed up would be in Isaac, that's for sure. So the episode went live recently where I missed a secret room at one point, so now I'm especially paranoid. It was in a random room though, so... Well, maybe it wasn't actually. I guess I'll use the last blank in the shop here. It's not here, fair enough. Good riddance. So we're leaving the floor with the exact same HP we started it on. That's not bad, I suppose. We'll save the membrane for the harder rooms on the floor, because I might have to use it on the boss depending on how things go. Oh, also, before I go back to that random tangent I was going to have, I totally forgot. I have some Patreon dedications to do. So this episode is going to be dedicated to Carnaris. Thank you very much for your support via Patreon. It helps let me do what I'm doing, which is apparently getting salty at Enter the Gungeon. I try not to get too salty, but Gungeon actually brings out much more salt than, say, Nameless King, because I guess the frustration with certain aspects of Gungeon is more consistent than just the odd boss or enemy in Dark Souls, which is unfair. I know that some people, for, you know, Schadenfreude or other reasons, also like seeing people get salty at stuff, as long as they're not getting salty at stuff. Alright, some people like watching other people get angry so that they don't have to. That's not the kind of market share I'm aiming for, so I try not to. That's why my usual response to getting annoyed at something is just to be quiet. Internal screaming, as they say. Nope. 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 I'd like it if the game jumped in the direction I told it to roll in, but that's okay, you don't need to. Why was that firing double that time? We have a heart on the floor, right? So that's not too terrible if we get hit again. We'll get armor, hopefully, from the boss, because we're not playing as the robot, so of course we will. Oh no, it was a key that dropped, yeah. And for once, I remembered not to take it before finding the shop. Oh, it's this room. Did this always bounce off the walls? I don't remember it doing that. Come on, March. I did not see the grenade behind me there, that was close. Alright, lots of ways to go. I want to find a night room with a good quality chest. This is not a night room with a good quality chest. Stop firing shapes at me! No. Okay then. We found our shop, so we know there's a key in here for sure. Ooh, Cog of Battle. Someone told me I think it was like it's a 50% damage increase on a successful reload. Cog of Battle is probably better than getting a key. Flame Hand is garbage. Oh, armor. Okay. Oh, you know, the room where you put the armor. Yeah, I think getting Cog of Battle would be a very smart choice. Hello, Cube, my nemesis. We could actually have ourselves a passive run here if I do decide to get Cog of Battle. Oh right, we've been to our shop. We'll take that key. We'll go back for this key as well. God, wouldn't it be awful if they changed it so the rat stole keys as well and they didn't tell anybody? Anyway, we have good keys, so now I'm not even worry about if I have to not buy a key on this floor, because Cog of Battle is more valuable now, especially because we have the three keys. Sorry, I kind of caught myself halfway through that sentence. Like, are you essentially saying the same thing at the start and end of that sentence? That's how I know that I was focusing on dodging and I was just saying words. Gungeon brings out a lot of that. Take the ammo for that for sure. Ooh, ho, 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 ho. Thank you for this gift you have bestowed. We shall just open this. I don't know what that is. Bullet bore. Oh yeah, so this is the Turok gun. I remember unlocking it, but I've never found it. The explosive drills this gun fires will stun enemies before exploding. The bullet bore is an exotic weapon from the past. An exotic weapon from the past, yes. When the only creatures to carry guns were dinosaurs. Yep, Turok reference. Alright, no secret room. It's only got one single giant boar bullet, so I assume that means it's a boss weapon, or maybe just an elite enemy weapon. I guess we'll give it a go when we find the boss of the floor. No sniper, bad sniper. Goodbye. Oh right, so the random tangent I was going to talk about. And this is another thing. Some people like hearing salt in Let's Plays, some people hate it. Some people like random tangent stories, some people hate it. You can't cater to everybody. But you may know if you've been watching my vlog updates, my channel did exceptionally well in Junior. Things are kind of going back down to normal now. In terms of like, you know, revenue and comments and... Views are still reasonably high, but they certainly aren't the ridiculous numbers it was in Junior. So anyway, I decided that I would treat myself to Vive because that's a virtual reality headset. Probably the best one on the market. Because I met the minimum criteria I wanted to for the month, where I decided I'd treat myself. Plus I can use it for business, class it as a business expense as well. You know, I've justified it to myself with all these reasons. But the thing that was kind of putting me off was Vive, or at least whoever's distributing it for them in the UK, they were trying to charge 80 quid for delivery of the damn thing, and that's on top of how expensive it already is. So I've really had a problem with that, because when you're making such an expensive purchase, they should be offering free next day delivery, quite frankly. Now, luckily, we're still missing an item room, aren't we? Yeah. Luckily, a UK game retailer has started stocking it. So I thought, okay, I've used them before, I know they're fine. They have a reward card system, so I'll get some money back. And the big part, they offer free next day delivery. So I thought, okay, fine, I'll order it now. I was going to wait until a bit later on, but yeah, sure, get it now. And I tried to, and I thought everything was fine. Then all of a sudden I got a text message from my bank saying, hey, we've noticed you're trying to do a charge of this amount of money. Is this actually legit? If it is, let us know. So I thought, okay, fine, that's their anti-fraud thing. They're just making sure I'm actually spending this much money, because it's a lot of money. So I did that, and I thought everything was fine. And then this morning when I looked at my email, I had an email from the retailer saying, hey, your order's cancelled because of reasons we're not allowed to say or can't say. Which was annoying, so I thought, right, fine, it probably means that the security check from the bank made them automatically cancel it. I'll just do it again now that I've told the bank that it's fine. Nope, still didn't work. It just got cancelled almost instantly again, so I don't know what's up. But my solution then was to instead go through PayPal rather than directly to my bank. But my PayPal also still goes to my bank. The downward boots, right? Yeah. So what I'm saying is, if this works, it shouldn't, but I think it will. Because, you know, I did this just before starting recording this episode, that's why it's on my mind, and I'm looking at my email I've got sitting in my other monitor. Because I want to get angry if I get another email saying it's cancelled, but at the same time, if I don't get an email saying it's cancelled, I'm still going to be angry, because I found a loophole of how to get past overly secure security for the bank, which is a good thing to have, incidentally. I'm not complaining about that. Oh, right, it drills into their skull for a little bit, then explodes. Because the fact I went through PayPal shouldn't matter if I'm still using the same debit card. That's what I'm meaning. So if I have found a loophole, it's probably something I should let them know. Not that it's not going to make your account get compromised or anything, but it's just weird, and it's bothering me. That said, I wouldn't mind if it works, because if it doesn't work, I don't know what to do. I think this is homing. Yeah, it totally is. It's also doing ridiculous amounts of damage. Jesus Christ. I wasn't really paying attention because I was too busy getting caught up on stupid ping for vibes. I better not be getting poisoned. Okay. Oh, isn't that... yeah, it makes a safe puddle if you're around you. So we got an HP up, we got an HP up, and we got armor. That's a pretty good haul. Let's see. We are definitely back. Well, actually, this bullet bore seems amazing, but Cog of Battle wouldn't really affect it, would it? Either way, it's so good, I'm gonna get it. Can we afford the key? Oh, we totally can! Alright, things are going well. We might end up just using the membrane as standard next floor then. Oh, secret room. I checked both the item rooms and it wasn't there. Not there either. We'll try the exit room. God damn it. An email just came in saying, hey, your order got cancelled again. Alright, so I didn't find a loophole, so that's good. But at the same time, why won't they let me spend my money? Is it a sign? Is it fate that's not letting me do this? That is so frustrating. Actually, what I'm now thinking it might be is maybe they don't have the stock they claimed they did. And this is just their excuse where they don't have any liability for not being able to fulfill the order. You have Cog of Battle, get used to it. My god, that's annoying. Hey, I want to spend quite a lot of money and I've chosen to do it at your retailer. No, we can't let you do that. Damn it. That's pretty good though. Nope. Right, need to get every gun's timing is a little bit different. Gotta get used to it. Yeah, killing them in two shots from just like one pellet from the shotgun, that's definitely above average damage. There we are. mean, I guess I could just go order from Five directly now, but I don't want to pay a ridiculous amount for postage. They're just trying to shaft you. Making room clearing a hell of a lot easier. Don't mind if I do. Hopefully we'll get the same level of ammo drops we've been getting on previous floors. We do still have our spacebar ammo drop though. I didn't reload that properly. Done and done. We only really technically need to get to the next floor and then this run has achieved something. A gun muncher. Nope. I don't have many guns and the guns I do have are pretty damn good. Let's check down here. I like being so fast as well. It's going to make the run just move so much smoother. No bubble crap. So, I was expecting this to just be a through room. It is not just a through room. Stay over there. Perfect timing. Oh, now that's interesting. Because that filled up my active clip, does that mean Cog of Battle is still in effect? Or is it not? There's no like visual indicator to know for sure. That I'm aware of, anyway. I'm pretty sure it's not because that took two shots. But that one only took one. We have not been to the shop yet. We shall wait. We'll just open it. Oh, that's another speed up, right? No, wait, no, that's massive accuracy up. We're playing as the character where that has the least effect, but muscle relaxant is still super good. This is actually a passive run. Oops. Alright, we found our shop. There will be a key. And there's nothing else we really want, so we'll buy the key. And we'll go back for that in a second. Oh, look, it's that room we get every single run, apparently. Actually, it's tightened up the spread of the shotgun, hasn't it? Yeah, it absolutely has. Let me check the description for muscle relaxant again. Alright, so that... It is technically an accuracy up, but... It's tightened the spread of shotguns, which I wouldn't necessarily call accuracy up. More like something to do with the spread, but... I didn't realise muscle relaxant did that. I thought it purely just meant my bullets would actually go where I'm firing for once. Which with shotguns doesn't generally matter as much. That's made the membrane even better. My god, this could carry us, assuming we keep on getting ammo. And then we just use the bullet borer for bosses. Hell, this might be even better for bosses, depending on the bonus damage. Didn't get it there. Looks like I'm trying to eat the bottom of the gun there. We knew it had to be a gun because the other one was a passive. Code 45, as far as I'm aware, is okay. I don't know if that still counts as Cog of Battle, so we'll just do it again just in case. Because I'll still save more ammo overall. Chickens. 7 out of 10. Nice. Got a lot of money there. Don't forget to go back for that key. In fact, do it now before you forget. We are so fast. Okay, let's go there. Still got another item room to find. Right? Yeah, because of the gun muncher. No, wait. No, we found both armors, we just need the boss now. Oh. A key for guaranteed armor plus something else. Yeah, sure, why not? I won't take that in case I get hit twice on the boss. I'll just have to try and remember and come back for it if I do. Alright, here we go. It's the tank. Let's see how much damage this does. That is pretty nice damage, but would this do more? I think it is still doing a bit. Oh wait, I do still get the reload for this? Shit, okay, hang on. It's really hard to focus on. I can't tell if these are hitting him or not. You bastard. Well, luckily we got 2 HP ups on the last floor, so that kind of counters this. Why am I sometimes getting 2 shots? Well, the problem is I can't make it fire at the tank. Fire at the enemies. It always fires at the biggest target, I guess. I need to remember and make sure that this gets the next ammo, because it's pretty amazing. Let's actually save the rest of it. Let's just burn down the tank. Where you at? Oh, there you are. Bye. Oh, we got an HP up anyway, okay. I don't think there was anything we wanted in the shop. You know what, I'm not going to use... Well, I could buy armor. No, I'll hold on to it. I'm not going to use my blanks to look for the secret room unless I know it's there for a fact. Because if you have more than 2, then you're still bringing down bonus blanks for the next floor. Alright, let's just go. We made it! We have the 20 hegemony credits for Elevator Man. So we have achieved something, even if the run was to end on this floor, although given the situation we're in, I don't think it will, unless we get no more ammo now. In fact, I might as well just use ammo drop on Bulletborn now while we're waiting on the bullet going. There, we've got a guaranteed boss weapon now. Hello, friend. There you go. That's everything. Meet me in the breach when you're done. We just got the achievement Going Downest. That's everything. Meet me in the breach. Okay. The run is technically over, but we might as well push on and try and get bullet hell, although with the lack of guns, I don't think that's viable. Okay. Love one-shotting them at this late stage. Perfect. Yeah, we don't need it for anything else. Get out of it. Oh, two-shotting, Tommy Gun Ghost at this late stage. Feels real nice, sure. I shouldn't have wasted my ammo drop, I guess, because apparently, for whatever reason, we're just getting lucky with ammo crate drops. Did I pick up a gun that maybe carries a secret luck up? I mean, coolness up in this one. Oh, we've got a king room, okay. Without dodge rolling. Do the room without dodge rolling. We done? We're done. We got Hegemony Carbine. We'll probably use that to clear the floor, this floor. It's obviously not as good. Oh, I can just walk across that. Probably shouldn't test that on the fly. With Cog of Battle, it might be pretty good. The Shock Grub. Oh, no, wait, no, this is a blooper. Fantastic knockback, but that's about it. Slow reload. Oh, damn, okay. He's selling some good stuff. Alright, we're going to have to wait and see how much money I have by the end of the floor. We'll definitely try and buy the commando. If I can't afford the commando... I haven't seen the shop yet, have I? Oops. Probably not as efficient as maybe using the rifle. Don't need that far. Let's just take it for that. We'll use this and see if it clears as fast. Where's the damn... There he is. Okay. Problem removed. Yeah, it seems pretty good. Yeah, we pretty much kicked the ass out of that golden skeleton. Hello, friend. This is just a through room for sure. No, never mind. No, it's not. Gotta start being aware of cape bullets now, though. Sure. I get so many ammo drops. I don't know why. We must have picked up something that had a secret coolness up. Maybe the bullet bore? Because it is pretty cool. That was what we got from the red chest, right? So that'd be my best bet. Unless muscle relaxant or something has a hidden buff. Or maybe the gun boots has a hidden coolness factor. You need a key to get in the shop. Screw you. Well, that's okay. We can work with the orc. That was a very poor dodge. Still alive. Ah. Oh, there. That covers that. I used that blank because the spawn was rather unfair. I think what you were supposed to do is jump into the middle of the room. Bad guess. The little slimes don't know what hit them. Actually, if I do the gun boot thing, they really don't. Oh, I'm sorry, are you all frozen? I'm gonna switch to one of our item rooms. We still have no keys, but we might as well look at the rarity. Oh, I very nearly jumped into the shot there. Thank you for the blank and the ammo. Well, blue quality, we wouldn't be missing much. Oh, didn't reload. Yeah. Let's check up here. If I do get one key, I'll probably end up just using it on the chest because we have the orc. And his store is pretty damn good. Nope. Nope, Mr. Buffy Man, you are not doing that. One item room. There's still another item room somewhere, right? Oh. Wait, it was right there. Okay, I want to go check... Let's not bother going to check the orcs' prices until after the boss. Bullet board is... Oh, it's the wall. I don't like the wall. I'm definitely not going to be able to focus on reloading and firing. Reloading and dodging! So it doesn't seem to be doing that much damage to him. Yeah, I don't think it's doing as much damage as something else could be. Let's try this. Yeah, it's doing much more. I think. It must have something to do with the way the bullet board does damage. It wasn't doing as much to the wall, I don't think, as other enemies. Or other bosses. He doesn't really have a head. What is this again? Oh, right, it's the wolf that attacks people. That's good. Okay. We didn't get a key, so we are just going to shoot the blue chest. Which, of course, I can get to from here. Not from where I was. How many bullet boards we got left? 59, that's still enough, probably. We still have 4 blanks as well, so I don't really want to go looking for a secret room. I'd rather just take what we got. We still have plenty of hegemony rifle rounds for the next floor. We can use the blooper if need be. I don't want to use the membrane now, because it just does too much damage to waste. We might need it for dragon. Shit. If only there was someone I could sell to. Didn't have quite enough. We've cleared all the rooms. Oh well. Well, down to Dragon we go. Super fast as well, getting to the 5th floor pre-40 minutes. There we are. Nope, don't want any part of this. Junior, could you go deal with that, please? I heard an explosion. Yeah. Why you gotta give me all the rooms I despise? There! That was actually not a bad layout, as far as those rooms go. Alright, we got the one that's trying to buff this, summon the skeleton, so that's fine. Devour him, Junior, devour him! Special room here of some kind. It's the guy that gives you a positive perk and a negative one. We're gonna ignore it. Almost certainly running out of ammo for this on this floor, but that's okay. We have alternatives. We can use the blooper, it's not ideal. We'll make it. Wow, did I just kill one of those tough things with one clip? Of a pretty crappy weapon? Oh. I don't remember picking up anything cursed, but okay. Oh wait, no, on floor 5 you always have just the chance. Fine, fine, fine. It's a shame we've had so few keys, but we've had so many ammo drops I can't complain because it's just been too good on that run. Which is just as well because this is a mostly passive run. Whoa, no, I hate the way they shoot where you're gonna go even if you don't know you're going that way yet. That wasn't a full clip that time. Wow. Being able to deal with them so easily is refreshing, especially if we get to bullet hell because there's tons of them down there. I didn't see the enemy. Oh no, we ran out. Blooper or the... No, we use the cold 45. We'll see how that does. Freezing enemies is valuable. Oh, we found the forge nice and early. Homing bullets, 104. Or another gun. Frost Giant is pretty good. We don't need the bullets. If we live, we're going to bullet hell. Homing bullets would be nice, but I feel like the thing I'm actually wanting is another gun option. Wow, we found dragon already? I might as well try and get to this island. We have one key, so I might as well use it. There's no item rooms, item chests. That's the word I was looking for. Got there in the end, in bullet hell. There's only pain and suffering. Get lost, slime. Slime that turns to fire can get lost. Doesn't seem like this gun has a particularly high freeze rate, but it's okay. Cog of Battle is now pretty much a top tier passive for me now, now that I understand just how significant the damage up is. Yeah, I didn't notice the hole. The freeze kind of builds up on them. Oh hey, we got more than what I took covered anyway. Oh hey, that's the diehard gun. So now I shoot my equipped item. So that means with bullet bore, I'm going to fire two bores. That's pretty nice. What am I doing here though? I'd have to clear one more room to afford either. Okay, we can do one more room. Where is one more room for doing down here? Damn shadow bullets. Oh, that's a shot every time I fire a shot. I was getting confused with something else. It's not just every time I roll I fire backwards, that's the down roll boost, which I also have, obviously, but... Homing bullets sounds like a good idea. I'm gonna risk not taking another gun. If I now run out of ammo, then obviously I made the wrong decision. Let's see how bullet bore does against Mr. Dragon. And if I see him chuck his knives, use a blank. I can't help but notice I'm only firing... I'm not firing at my ass. I have an error I wish to report regarding an item in the game. No, either way, we damage this. Oh wait, no, hang on, no, they are firing sometimes. No, it's not coming out the... It's not coming out the butt, it's coming out the front. That would explain the damage. Maybe some of the highest damage I've ever done to the dragon, ever. They're also destroying his fire a little bit. Oh, that did not work as I intended. You've got to be really fast to stop him doing those. You know what? No. Wow, that was quick. Yes, hello Maya, I see you sneaking your head around the door. It's not time yet. You've got 20 minutes until that certain meal that you're waiting for. Would it have been smarter to keep more bullet bore ammo for the Lich, assuming we got there? Almost certainly. We might find armor on the way. Ammo, rather. That isn't actually doing as much in phase 2 as I was expecting. Let's use probably just that. Probably the most comfortable dragon fight I've ever had. I only used two blanks as well, so it didn't matter that I had the bonus ones. And we did it without getting hit, so we got plus one HP. Good. Good. Sadly, we're just going to be using this as our room clearer. And hell, we have to try and find the Lich quick, because if we don't, we're going to get worn down, lack of ammo, etc, etc. Let's see how it goes. Must remember, after this run, go talk to Elevator Man. See what he has to say. Alright, kill the demons, kill the shotguns that fire like rocket-shaped bullets. I wonder how homing my butt bullets are going to be. I've kind of stuck myself in a bullet in a hard place. Bullet in a hard place, that was an accidental pun. Rock in a hard place here, by not moving from the door. With these things coming towards me. Hello, friend. Why won't you die? Oh. This has a limited range. The Cold 45 is going to run out of ammo real soon. Right, get rid of the devil bullets, then the priest bullets. Oh no! Oh, oh, oh! He's got a cape! Don't keep in him. Junior, if you hit him, I'm going to be pissed off. He's leaving him alone. Alright, good. So this will be the third time I've let the caped bullet escape. Once he sods off. Hello, friend. I don't want to accidentally touch you. I'm not going to do anything to you. You've just to leave, okay? You have to go away. I'll stand over here. See, I'll destroy these candles because I'm a vandal. Who's a good junior not attacking the bullet that you know you're not supposed to attack? He's got more restraint than I do. My patience, however, is being tested. Come on. Okay, good. Wait, there's another wave after him? Shit! I looked away. I was looking at the recording window, and it's delayed. Right, we're going to have to use the blooper now, unfortunately. I say unfortunately just because it's much weaker than what we were using. Now that will knock down the skelly. There we go, that's the way. I have to find the lich real soon. Oh good, more cursed enemies. It is doing a lot of damage. The blooper doesn't have good range though. Oh, I should have looked at the map. This is obviously not going to be the right way. Is that reload up? All these have one hit in them anyway. I'll let Junior handle them. Wow. Another blank is really helpful. It's got to be up that way. It wouldn't be below the way I came in. Wow, two shot in one of them is pretty significant. The mutants are taking more than that. Oh, he's firing the stupid rocket bullets. Only two blooper rounds left. It's not going to be enough. I'm going to run out of ammo. Of course we don't get ammo drops on this floor. Alright. Ah! Ooh! To think real carefully what I take this for. The membrane's still got okay ammo. It's gotta be bullet bore, right? Shit. It's gotta be bullet bore. It is really good damage. If I don't find the lich soon, then that was a mistake. Okay, these guys are easy enough that we can finish them off with our basic gun. I'm gonna have to start being very careful with my remaining membrane ammo. Look at the key when it no longer matters. That went better than I was expecting, let's put it that way. I didn't see the goddamn devil behind me. What is this spawn? Jesus. Okay. We've still got the two blanks we started with. That slime that's chasing you is a lure. It's deliberately meant to distract you. He is not the biggest threat here. Maybe when he explodes he is, but prior to that, nah. Devils, shotguns, ghost bullets, they're all much more threatening. Yes, I am using my starting weapon on hell. Thank you for noticing, although we just maybe got a reprieve right there. Looper or hegemony rifle, or just restored. Now, the membrane's close enough to max it, it doesn't matter. The blooper I was underestimating. Its range is crap, but its damage is probably better than the hegemony rifle. Absolutely not to him. Give me the lich. This is a big room. Big rooms on bullet hell don't agree with me. Oh, the blooper is definitely not reaching him. Take out the small fry first. I think Junior is actually attacking him, and then we'll go like normal pistol. And then we can go back to the blooper. Oh. We need to get in there. Stop giving me keys! Also, this was a dead end, damn it. Out. You can rage all you want, walk right into that shot. Did I just see that this was another dead end? That's okay, the first bit of damage we've taken for the whole floor or just in a while? This is a dead end though, so it was a waste of time coming this way. I knocked him clean over that gap, did you see that? Oh wait, no, there's a way up here. Oh, the boss, okay. Bullet borer, we have enough ammo that we should be okay. I want to make sure my first shots are powered up. Let's do this. Save the blanks for form 2. Even if it means taking damage. The explosions are actually keeping his bullets from reaching full spread as well. Wow, we are kicking his ass. That might be the fastest I've only fought him and beat him like twice. Yep, then you do the grabby thing. Now fast forward, we know this. Wear him down. Oh, I jumped off the edge. Oh wait, no I didn't. Apparently. Are you using that item from Isaac that makes you fire through walls? Ooh, okay. Is that it? We done? We're not done. Shit! Oh, he's not got a lot of HP though. It's kinda low compared to... No, that's moving too fast. Memory. He's firing rocket ships at me. Nope. Don't know what this is, but don't do it. Nope. Variable speed is screwing me over. Kill him! Ooh, I did it with half a heart! You better be dead now. That last four. Oh, you're done. Disappear. Riddle of Lead unlocked. Gungeon Master achievement unlocked as well. Gungeon Blueprint unlocked. Anything else? Ooh, I think that was the true ending. I did it with half a heart. I had exactly enough HP. Only because there was something up with the timing of that last attack he was doing. I need to watch that back to try and learn that better, because I was messing that up something fierce. No, well, we shot the Gungeon in the head. Nobody, you did great. Riddle of Lead, Gungeon Blueprint. Just a pile of ash. Right, let's quickly go back and talk to Elevator Man, and then that's where we're going to be ending this episode. Doesn't really matter who I'm playing as for. Let's see what he has to say. We've got Gungeon unlocked. Oh yeah, while I was working I found this. I fell down the shaft though, so who knows where it might turn up. Yes, I wonder what else is hidden in these shafts. Finally, the last elevator. This one is just completely... What? Completely plus? I'll see you in the maintenance room in Chamber 5. Oh god, there's more to do. Ah! And with that, thank you for watching. Ta-ta for now.